The spectacular Himalayas are the highest mountains in the world, separating the lowlands of India to the south from the Tibetan plateau in the north. This incredible mountain range can be traced for 2,400 kilometers, or 1,500 miles, and includes more than 50 peaks over 7,200 meters, or 23,600 feet above sea level. The Himalayas are all the more impressive because of the rocks that formed them, and they have risen from where they were deposited on the seafloor during the Mesozoic era, the age of the dinosaurs, more than 65 million years ago. What caused this greatest of all Earth's mountain belts to rise out of the sea? We have known since plate tectonic theory was established 50 years ago that the Himalayas mark where two continents, India and Eurasia, collided. It was this collision that uplifted the Himalayas to their incredible heights. We also know that before this continental collision, India was part of the supercontinent Gondwanaland, separated from Asia by thousands of kilometers of a great east-west ocean called Tethys, named after a Greek goddess. India broke out of Gondwanaland about 120 million years ago, in the early Cretaceous time, and moved rapidly across Tethys to begin colliding with Asia about 50 million years ago. But we have not known what ripped India from Gondwanaland and sent it north. Or maybe we should say that we have not known until now. A new explanation for India's northward flight is offered in a new paper by geoscientists from the University of Texas at Dallas and published in the journal Geoscience Frontiers. Graduate student Haoyu Hu and Professor Robert Stern found the answer in ancient seafloor rocks preserved in southern Tibet called ophiolites. Ophiolites are especially important for reconstructing Earth's plate tectonic history. Ophiolites consist of oceanic crust and mantle that has been thrust up on land where geologists can study them. Ophiolites consist of mantle rocks called peridotite, and a variety of crustal rocks that are easily distinguished from the continental crust that they are emplaced upon. Ophiolite crust includes pillow basalt, which only forms when lava erupts on the seafloor. The Himalayan ophiolites mark the actual suture between India and Asia, where the Tethys Ocean once existed. The UTD team showed that these ophiolites formed when and where a new subduction began to form about 120 million years ago on the southern margins of Asia. The sinking of oceanic plates in subduction zones is known to be what powers plate motions. Formation of a new subduction zone on the southern margin of Asia would have pulled strongly on Gondwanaland to the south, pulling India out and starting it on its northward journey. The Tethys Ocean narrowed as India moved north, consumed by the new subduction zone, until India collided with Asia to form the Himalayas we see today.